The Grove on the campus of Ole Miss in Oxford, Mississippi. One of the most popular pregame tailgating spots in all of college football. You add to the mix today's opponent, undefeated Alabama, and this place is filled to capacity. They're all hoping, Ole Miss fans that is, that Hugh Freeze, the coach, and Bo Wallace, the quarterback, can lead Ole Miss to its first 5-0 record since 1962. Ole Miss against Alabama. On CBS, the Alabama Crimson Tide 4-0, the Rebels of Ole Miss likewise undefeated. This is a pivotal early season game. Mississippi State playing at home, having its way with previously undefeated Texas A&M, Alabama and Ole Miss here, and later tonight, Auburn tees up against LSU. Hi, once again, everybody. Vern Lundquist along with Gary Danielson. We welcome you to this much-anticipated game. You know, previously when we've done Ole Miss, they've always kind of been the other team. Not in this game. They've earned equal billing. Now the question, Gary, are they up to the task?
I think they are. And, you know, when we talk to the players, Vern, what I liked is I say, are you guys ready? And to a man, they all said, we're ready to compete. Not ready to win. We're ready to compete. And I like that. I think they know that it's a tough task, but they want the challenge, and I think they're up for the challenge. And because they've got athletes on that defense, they're going to keep this game close because they've got power. They've got speed and quickness. They've got a front four that will disrupt with veteran athletes in the back of the secondary. This defense believes they're good enough to play with anyone, let alone Alabama.
Well, you talk to these very rabid Ole Miss fans. They talk about the quarterback, Bo Wallace, and what you hear is, well, there's the good Bo and there's the bad Bo.
That's been the theme all week, I think, and Bo bristled when we brought that up. You know, I think for him, he just has to look back to a year ago when he had an outstanding game against number 6 LSU. He went 30 for 39 a year ago. Now, this year he's been off and on, hot and cold, but he's done it in a big game, in a 27-24 win a year ago. But he has to be more than a game manager. When teams beat Alabama, good quarterback play is the main reason.
Well, one of the great stories early in this 2014 season has been the emergence of Blake Sims, a fifth-year senior quarterback for Alabama. He's been great so far. Today's his first road game.
And it'll be different. I really think it will be different. I mean, the crowd will affect it. Alabama's going a little bit more no huddle. But you know what? I think an athlete first who loves competing and being a quarterback. So far, when you talk to opposing coaches, they bring up his name first. And that means when you bring up Blake Sims, you save maybe the best player for second because he's got a guy he can lean on. When things get tough, he can create a pressure point, which I think the best player in college football right now, Cooper, has been able to distort defenses and, more importantly, change defenses so the other guys for Alabama can make their plays. Alabama might be their best offense they've had since I've been in the league.
We will be filled beyond capacity at Vaught Hemingway, and we'll continue from Oxford after this. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by NAPA. Verizon. AutoTrader.com. And by Chick-fil-A. Thank you. at Vaught Hemingway. Capacity listed just over 60. We'll have a little more than that. And now we take you first on the field, presented by Microsoft Surface. And moments ago, first on the field, the Rebels of Ole Miss. Only two touchdowns allowed, one passing, one running so far this year. And right behind them, playing their first true road game of the season, they did take on West Virginia in a neutral site. But here come the Crimson Tide of Alabama. And a moment ago, Allie the Force with Ole Miss head coach Hugh Freeze.
Coach, this is the biggest game in recent history for Ole Miss. How have you prepared your team?
Well, we've tried to treat it just like every game. You know, we try to prepare each day just to make sure that everything we're doing is keeping us in the moment and preparing us for that Saturday. But it would be hard to stand here and say that there hadn't been a little extra attention on this one. And, you know, we're honored to be in a game like this in our short tenure here. Hopefully we're in a lot more, and hopefully we find ourselves worthy today to compete.
You told me to win this game today. Bo Wallace needs to have a near perfect game. What was your message to him before the game?
Just to play within yourself. It's okay to use your feet. It's okay to throw it away. It's okay for us to punt. Don't be afraid to use your checkdowns, and just to try to keep us on schedule.
Good luck, Coach. Thanks.
Thank you.
Allie, thank you. There is the senior quarterback, Bo Wallace. It just couldn't be more perfect. 63 degrees. Thunderstorms, tornado threats were prevalent in this area two nights ago. But it is a beautiful afternoon. Alabama leads the all-time series. There were three wins vacated and one forfeited, so the actual record you see, 47-9-2. And Alabama has won the last 10 games between these two universities. Nick Saban, eighth-year head coach. Ole Miss won the toss. They've elected to take the ball. And that means that Jalen Walton, number six, is back to return Adam Griffith's kick. Short. It's Mark Dotson instead, the short man. One man shoved out of bounds from behind. Christian Jones caught up with him.
You know, Vern, because of the wind conditions, Alabama was forced to hold the ball on the tee. It was not a good kick. It was very low, as you called it, and that's really what caused the return. No height on that kick at all. I think they're going to call it out about the 37 to 38 yard line.
A 62-yard gain. Take a look, Gary.
Yeah, never got more than maybe 15 feet in the air. Look at that, see? And that, the coverage was nowhere near the play and created the seam right away.
That's Griffith with the miss. And then Christian Jones, number 22. It's a first down at the 39. Quarterback draw called all the way. And Bo Wallace inside the 30.
You know, what's very interesting is I would have assumed in this game that Alabama would try to get Blake Sims off on the game throwing, and just the opposite for Ole Miss, established the running game for the quarterback. Very important, very clever play calling by both sides.
Jalen Walton is the running back. Off to the left. Oh, boy. No gain. That was Reggie Ragland, number 19. Well, Bo Wallace out of Pulaski, Tennessee. And in his third year now, he went to Arkansas State, where he was redshirted. Wanted to go to Tennessee. The head coach, Lane Kiffin, then didn't show any interest. There is a player down. It's Denzel Duvall, number 30.
Yeah, one of their talented outside pass rushers, too. I wonder if he got an ankle on the play. Did someone? Yeah, he actually got buckled on the block. And as he planted his, I think it was his left ankle, it just buckled on him. Yeah, it's his left ankle.
Mm.
right side of the screen. Watch as he takes on the blocker and just buckles that ankle. You know, Vern, we talk about good bow, bad bow, and that's all fair. When you play quarterback, it goes with the territory. However, I don't think Ole Miss can win this game if they don't help in the running game. The last 2 years, they've run for 40 yards and 86 yards. It isn't going to matter. They got to run with more yards than that, and it has been a trend in the SEC. Teams that beat Alabama run more than they throw.
And what they face is an Alabama defense that gives up 62 yards per game. So they are stalwart. Here's Wallace on a line, tipped and incomplete. That was close. Cody Core, number 88. Cy Jones got there to tip it away.
Yeah, Cy Jones was there, and a safety cut underneath it, but the ball was thrown high enough. If the ball had been thrown lower, I believe Landon Collins would have intercepted that ball.
Ole Miss now trying not to waste the opportunity given it after the 62-yard kickoff return. Third down, 10.
Now it's got to be a zone. Nobody's covering the two slots. Got to be a zone coverage, or Alabama's misaligned. Look at this. There's three players, and there's nobody over it. So you would assume they're going to bail back out into zone coverage.
Timeout. Ole Miss.
Interesting.
I think everybody in Ole Miss said, what the heck's going on here? It doesn't even look right.
Well, we had an electrifying start. Been kind of sloppy since. Time call.
Well, one more look at this. Three wide receivers for Ole Miss out here. Eight men in the box. Now, you would assume that Alabama was going to fly out of it, but Ole Miss didn't know for sure. And on their first third down and long, they didn't want to take the chance of getting a sack or a blitz. And it was so unorthodox that Ole Miss goes, hey, we've never seen anything like that before.
Vince Sanders, number 10, heads out to the left side on this third down play. And they've got three bunched short side of the field to the right.
And they're going to play zone again.
Delayed blitz. That catch is made, but short of the first down.
Yeah. Big decision. Remember, in the game in Tuscaloosa a year ago, Hugh Freeze was 0 for 3 on fourth down. He said if he had to do it again, he'd kick field goals, but this one's tempting.
Laquan Treadwell, number 1, made the catch.
They've got that heavy package.
Yeah, that's right. Well, that's Ben Still. The center goes back out.
Big Jeremy Liggins, number 15, a 300-pound tight end quarterback, is in the game as well.
Massive defensive changes now. And Liggins is 5 yards back.
Another
timeout. Timeout again.
It's under further review.
Got a break, Ole Miss did.
So the timeout not charged to them.
Both teams have that heavy offense. Remember for Alabama a few years ago was Terrence Cody that played it. Now this one, as the clock goes down, the replay booth is going to take a look to make sure the spot is as close to where it has to be for this important fourth down play. So our booth guys called that before Ole Miss had to take a timeout, because they were going to take a timeout. Isn't that funny? When we visited with Hugh Freeze, he said, boy, if I had to do it over, I would really like to have kicked the field goals. But fourth and short, first drive. See what we do. Here's the catch again. Right on the line. I think it's right. It's true. Can't move the ball. I don't think, if I'm the replay official, I don't see anything where I could have an overrule of what happened on the field there.
Could he be looking at the legality
of whether he caught it? Well, that's interesting. I hadn't thought of that.
Rocky Ford is the replay official today.
Rocky Good.
Rocky Good.
Yes.
I'm thinking Rocky Four. I don't know why I'm thinking of that.
That's all right.
Thank you. Mid-courses corrections are always welcome.
If he blows one, he'll be known as Ford from now on. Yeah, I think that's a pretty good call right on the line there.
I did too.
And I personally think he caught it.
Matt Leffler is our referee today.
After further review, the receiver landed out of bounds when he caught the ball. Therefore, it's an incomplete pass. It's fourth down at the 29-yard line.
I thought he had his feet down. You know, his chest came down. That's a Rocky Good overruled me and you that time.
Yeah.
Yeah, his elbow came down before his thigh. He was right. That's a big call.
That's why we call him Rocky Good. 46-yard field on the tip.
I'm sitting there watching the catch and not his body.
Gary Wunderlich, number 97, is the long-distance field goal kicker, and got it! He was ejected from last week's game against Memphis. Wunderlich, that is his first field goal attempt of the season. We went back and looked at the tape of his ejection and probably shouldn't have been thrown out.
Somebody else should have been.
Exactly.
And just enough on this one.
We invite you to follow Alabama, Ole Miss, or your favorite team all on your phone. Download the CBS Sports app now and never miss a moment of the action. Injury update. Let's go down to Allie LaForce.
Thanks, Vern. Gary, you were right. Denzel Duvall, it was a left foot injury. He was taken right to the trainer's table where they cut his tape off and started pressing around on the top of his left foot. That's when they knew immediately there was an injury serious enough to where he could not go back in. They immediately put him in a boot, and he was taken off the field on crutches.
All right, Allie, thank you. Gary Wunderlich, who just authored that 46-yard field goal, will kick off. Christian Jones is one of the deep men. Landon Collins is also back. Heading to the left corner, grabbed at the three by Christian Jones. Slips another tackle. And one more. He is finally dropped at the 42-yard line. Keith Lewis, number 24. That's a 38-yard kick.
Yeah, another Alabama football player down on the field injured. Also, Christian Jones, the dangerous returner for Alabama.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, I think it was Kenyon Drake, to tell you the truth. Numbers. I thought it was 47 at first, but I do think it's 17.
He was one of the stars of the most recent victory over Florida when he scored on the first play from scrimmage, an 87-yard pass.
You know, Vern, the Ole Miss fans saw Jones with that ball and went, uh-oh, because he had a 99-yarder last year against him, kickoff.
Mm.
Kenyon Drake, who, well, we know what the first play's not going to be this week.
That's right.
A couple weeks ago, it was a slant and go. You know, really, as you look at him go off, that's really one of the weapons that Lane Kiffin's used, the three different headed back.
Take a look at the right side.
Yeah, his own guy from behind. Dallas Lee.
Yep.
Dylan Lee, excuse me. Dallas was his brother.
First and 10, Alabama's first snap with the football. Sims will keep it.
Both teams start out getting their quarterback involved. How about that?
Well, let's reintroduce you to Blake Sims, sat patiently behind A.J. McCarron. McCarron, a starter for 3 years, but Sims really has blossomed this year.
Yeah, he's turned in from a disastrous spring game where they thought, uh-oh, to being one of the true weapons on this football team.
T.J. Yeldon, number four, gets the handoff. Nice little move at the line of scrimmage. And that will allow Alabama to have a first series of downs. The remainder of the offense, you've got the freshman at left tackle and Quanjo Kelly Brown Shepherd. And down at the bottom, DeAndre White. He was injured in the very first game. After he had caught six passes in that game, had to sit out two, and he caught six more against Florida. He's a very valuable part of this offense. Yeldon lines up. There's a quick flip. Sims out to Amari Cooper. They've got him. Tony Connor, number 12, the Husky, or Nickelback, made the stop.
When you put on tape of this secondary and linebacker crew for Ole Miss, one of the things that stand out is they don't get blocked. The linebackers get away from wide receiver blocks, and the secondary does just good as well. They're as good as I've seen at handling those bubble screens this year.
No gain for Cooper, second down and 10. Here's Yeldon. Again, nice moves as he crosses the line of scrimmage. Defensively for Ole Miss, you saw the graphic earlier, only two touchdowns allowed. Kim Dichi is the number one pick from a year ago. D.T. Shackelford, a six-year senior. Wonderful young man, wears number 38 in honor of Chucky Mullins. Here's Vogler, and let's see if they give him progress to the point where he reached. I think so.
And
yes.
First down. How about how decisive Blake Sims is in knowing where to go with the ball? He's very well coached. You know, his fifth year senior experience, whether he's played or not, he's been in the program. He's listened. You know, he sat behind AJ, heard how to run this offense. He's getting that ball in and out of his hands because remember, that Ole Miss front four pass rush is a big weapon.
High formation on first down and 10. Jalston Fowler is the fullback. He leads the way for Yeldon. And this time, fewer yards, about two. There's a struggle for the ball.
Yeah, that ball might have popped out.
Did it? Well, the Rebel came out of the pile with it.
Well, Yeldon doesn't think so. He's walking back as calm as you can be.
Now, suck it down.
Yep.
I know if I was calling plays against Ole Miss, I would try to pound them a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Their outside defensive ends love to run the rush the passer, and they seem to feed that land shark mentality off their tackles for loss and sacks.
And Derrick Henry, who is the largest of the trio of backs, is behind Sims. He gets the hand, goes right. Vogel can't help as ball. Number 94, Dakota Ball, who could not help with the block. And C.J. Johnson made the tackle.
C.J. Johnson, they say it's a 4-2-5, but you look at number 10 as he gets double-teamed right there. He's really an outside linebacker. He ran off both those guys to make that tackle. That was a good play by C.J.
Third down, 9.
And the best third down team in the country.
Sims, he'll come short, and that should mean the presence of Adam Griffin, redshirt freshman, sophomore, beg your pardon.
You know, about everybody did their job here. In the back seven, good coverage. Cooper covered at the bottom of the screen, nowhere to go. And the offensive line for Alabama did a good job. Nothing there.
Here's Griffith. 8 years ago today, he was adopted and immigrated from an orphanage in Warsaw, Poland. That's not the way to celebrate. That's his second miss of the season. Second miss in a row. Adam Griffith, formerly known as Andres Dabowski, pushes it wide right.
All
Gary Danielson and I have been here a couple of times before. Allie LaForce has not. So she was invited to make her first visit to the Grove. Allie?
Vern, I was told that if I was going to do an Ole Miss game, I had to make my way down to the Grove. One of the most exciting tailgating experiences in all of the SEC. I am on the Walk of Champions, the exact sidewalk that the team walks down 2 hours prior to the game. We're talking themed tents, chandeliers, catered food, even dogs dressed up as football players. It doesn't get any better than this. This is the epitome of tailgating in the SEC, and it has not let me down. It has been an awesome welcome to the SEC.
Well, that was taped a couple of hours before a kickoff.
It probably looks just like that now.
That's what I'm thinking. We talked to some folks last night who have one of the tents in the Grove and have for 30 years. What time do you normally go to the game? I don't know. Didn't seem any matter of urgency.
Look at Ole Miss using this sugar huddle here. Real quick turn around and snap the ball.
On first down, reverse, left side. Quincy Adebayo, Boy Joe, sorry. Let's set the Ole Miss offense. Laramie Tunsil, his coach Dan Warner says he's the best offensive tackle he has ever coached. Morris, still Bell, Cooper. Ingram is the starting tight end. Mathers, Sanders, and the rest. Second down, 11. Wallace into the flat. Itavius Mathers.
And Mathers made the Alabama secondary miss. A little shake one-on-one and makes a miss. That is not easy to do against these Alabama defensive backs. They usually come up and handle those backs out of the backfield.
Third and two.
Yeah, that extra 4 yards really changes this.
Yes, got it. That's Evan Ingram, one of three tight ends that we will see today. That's his 15th catch of the year. Defensively for the Crimson Tide. Allen Robinson, DJ Petway gets the start in this 3-3-5 defense, at least for now. First down 10. 3-0, 46-yard field goal from Gary Wunderlich. They come right, little deception. And Itavius Mathers gets out near the 47-yard line.
If you go back and look at Alabama, when they have lost football games, there's two main reasons. They get an excellent quarterback against them. You know, you can think of the name from Tebow to Cam Newton to, you know, last year Trevor Knight had that big game in the bowl game. But the other part of it is the team does not give up on the running game. You just look at it, they run way more than they pass the ball.
Quick snap, and Alabama should be caught with men, extra men on the field. There is no flag.
Yeah, I'm pretty surprised.
I can't believe there wasn't a flag thrown.
The only possibility is they only have 10 men on the field, and it was a misalignment, and it was what it was. They did not have enough guys on the field. They're going to take one guy off, they're going to bring two on.
Now look at this, Gary. Kirby Smart is having problems with his defensive substitution.
Well, just, you know, last play they only had 10. That's why there was not a call on the play.
That was a 15-yard gain, a 3-0 gain. Wallace, nice. That's Mathers. First down, out of bounds to stop the clock at the 28.
There's really no excuse for this if you're Alabama. You've had 2 weeks to work on this. They know after plays you're going to get an up-tempo type game against them, especially after first downs. When you try to do too much defensively, you get calls like that.
First down, 10.
For sure knows that there was a blitz, safety blitz called. They check out, so Alabama checks out and goes two high safeties.
Wallace backs over throw, got it. Cody Core, the slot receiver,
You know, Vern, you asked me, are we going to get the good bow or the bad bow? Well, on this one, you got the very good bow, because that is a tough throw that Eli or Archie Manning would be proud of.
You bet.
There. I'm intrigued because he did have, admittedly, let's take first of all the Verizon red zone stats right at the national average. Bo played very poorly in the first half against Boise State, and he played very poorly in the first half against Memphis last week. Other than that, pretty good.
Yes, but those were the big games he played into.
There you are.
Okay. So you're not going to be able to pass that away. Let's just, every game's its own, and I know as a senior he's looking forward to this game at home.
Alabama with four down. Wallace, swing pass.
So defended so well that time by Alabama. They saw it coming. Nick Perry anticipated the play, defended well. Watch Perry come out of the secondary, whisk the motion, takes the man, and there's nowhere to go with the football. Number 27 anticipates the wheel route. Beautifully defended that time by Kirby Smart's defense. And
Ryan Anderson is the guy who got to Wallace.
And Ryan's in there because Duvall's not.
10th play of the drive. It's third down and 10. Into the middle, that'll set up a field goal.
Well, that's two big stops by this Alabama defense. You know, one on the long, you know, listen, everybody's charged up for this game. You know if you're Alabama, you're going to catch their best charge early in the game. So the kickoff goes down, and they stop them for a field goal. And now after a little bit of success, they shut them down again with a negative play to start it and then some good defense.
Now here is the short field goal kicker, Andrew Fletcher for Ole Miss. This from 33. He's 3 of 5 for the year. Uh-huh. Now he's 3 of 6.
It's hard to change that. Whatever. I'm not out there at practice every day. You would think if the long guy can make him long, you should be able to make him short.
Remember, Alabama did the Jeremy Shelley.
Yeah. How'd that work?
Kate Foster thing. Not really well, I seem to recall. Number 9, Amari Cooper, in the middle of that huddle, the All-American wide receiver, is the subject of our Home Depot Tools for Success.
Well, pick a tool. He's got it. I mean, he has the speed, top-end speed of, you know, the elite receivers, can judge the football as good as I've seen, has strength through the football. This is where he does remind me of Chris Carter, who has worked with Cooper on this. He goes up and he's very physical with the football, especially on those high throws. And then he's patient. Watch how patient here. Never in a hurry to get into his route and gives a quarterback a lot of space to throw the football. He is one of those guys that's unique to college football in that in any other sport he'd already be a professional. He's still playing college football and he will create a pressure point.
Last time we saw him, he had 10 catches for 201 yards. That was 2 weeks ago in the win over Florida. Sims with the play fake. Chased a little to his right, goes deep, and that's caught by O.J. Howard. Talented tight end, only his third catch this year.
Yeah, I tell you, you know, the more you watch Blake Sims, the more you say, like, what was the big decision? I mean, this guy just doesn't make any mistakes. Moves back in the pocket, throws under pressure. That time Isaac Gross had a pop on him and nothing.
There's Cooper's second catch.
Let's go back to Amari Cooper and some of the mismatches in this game he's going to have. You know, he goes up and gets that ball as a 6'1 receiver. And in this game for Ole Miss, the corners are 5'8, 5'9-ish. That'll mean that Ole Miss and Dave Womack, their defensive coordinator, will have to put safeties up to help. That's Senquez Golson, number right there, number 21. 5'8". Number 28, Mike Hilton, 5'9". It's a tough matchup for those corners.
DeAndre White, bottom of the screen. Sims out of the backfield to Yeldon. He slips. Felt the presence of Tony Connor, number 12.
Well, if you look at T.J. Yeldon, he had, remember, the big run last year in this game, a 68-yarder that broke the game open. He's not the feature guy because it's been a passing attack. For the first time in my memory, I think since Nick Saban has been here, the star of the team is not the running back. It's a wide receiver. Every other year, it's been a running back.
Ingram, Lacy, guys like that. Here's Sims dropped.
Oh, my.
O.J. Howard had a first down.
Yeah.
And instead, Alabama will punt.
Against Big Five conferences, Alabama came into this game converting 68% of their third downs. Obviously, that should have been a conversion. I mean, O.J. batted that one down.
That brings on J.K. Scott, true freshman out of Denver, Colorado. His first punt memorably went for 62 yards. This is only the sixth punt in the fifth game. And it will go over the head of the returner. Bounces into the end zone, touchback. TV's number one comedy is Genius. Join Emmy winner Jim Parsons and the rest of the gang on a new Big Bang Theory. New night, Monday at 8, 7 Central, only CBS.
I know you're looking at me, but you did did it perfectly.
Well, that's why I'm looking at you. I needed approval.
Last week, he stumbled through the Big Bang.
Yeah, the Big Bang
it's
Theory.
It's the biggest show on CBS.
I heard about
but
it.
But we're doing the biggest game in the best conference, so that's what we got to concentrate on right now.
Only CBS. First down, 10. Wallace, right side.
Yeah, well defended.
Vince Sanders, number 10.
Yeah, Tony Brown, the true freshman that time out there, very patient. He made sure the ball was thrown short, and then more importantly, he wraps up yards after catch and makes sure the big receiver does not get away.
There is a flag.
Number 75 on the offense. That's a 5-yard penalty. Repeat, first down.
Yeah, he actually, I think he was downfield by a lot. That he did not hear that play at all.
It's Robert Conyers, the fifth or sixth offensive lineman. He's a backup. There's Conyers.
You're allowed to go 3.5 yards downfield, and that was close, but I would always lean for it. That's the most unfair rule I've ever heard of. Does that make sense?
Yes, and I've heard you say that. Why do you think so?
The spirit of the game was the linemen were downfield blocking because of the option teams, and the rule was put in because there's a lot of forward laterals in option football. Well, now the coaches have taken advantage of this and are calling a combination of run plays and pass plays. A lot of times linebackers are getting blocked on pass plays. I think they need to look at that rule and put it back to 1 yard.
Well, I heard someone say to you before the game that you alone are responsible for getting the targeting rule changed. I'm just here to set you up.
Man, well done.
LeBron Treadwell. Ball loose? No. Well, we're in the north central part of the state. Ole Miss and Mississippi State, first time they both started 4-0. First time both ranked at the same time. First time both ranked in the top 15 since 1958, and Mississippi State will only go up in the polls.
That's pretty impressive, wasn't it?
Yes. Five wides on 3rd and 10.
Looks like a three-man rush, or will they come from the second level?
Punting situation. That was Markell Pack, number 11.
A lot of kind of different looks for Alabama. Remember, they had an off week to prepare for this football game. I'm sure they, you know, as Nick always does, no stone unturned. And they look like they're giving them a few different looks in that pass rush that Ole Miss is not handling well.
Will Gleason, first punt of the game. averaging 44.4. Christian Jones is back. Jones is going to let it bounce. It takes an Ole Miss roll and will limp to a stop at the 30-yard line. They've covered the most memorable games and competed at the highest levels in sports. Don't miss what these women have to say. We need to talk. Tuesday nights at 10 Eastern only on CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Week one went on the air last Tuesday night and received very favorable reviews. Our own Allie LaForce, former colleague Tracy Wolfson.
Yeah, they did good. I watched it.
Yeah.
I taped it. I don't stay up that late anymore. Unbalanced line to the right for Alabama here. See if they try to get the toss game going.
Derrick Henry is in it, running back. They try the right side with Derrick Henry and get a few. Well, interesting. First quarter of play. It opened with a 62-yard kickoff return. Ole Miss was able to get a 46-yard field goal. Both teams have missed field goals since then. 3-0. Ole Miss will return to Oxford after this message and a word from your local station. Back to Vaught Hemingway Stadium, Ole Miss Campus, Oxford, Mississippi. Yeah, I looked into the stands and was surprised to see the musical star Katy Perry recognized her right away. She's got a bear hug from the mascot. I can't keep a straight face.
I was going to say, in my life, I never thought I'd hear Vern Lundquist and Katy Perry in the same sentence.
Oh, Lord's will, perhaps, but you know. We start quarter number two.
That's a new one for me right there.
Oh, goodness. Second down and 9. Sims, good downfield coverage. He throws it away as he hustles out of bounds. Well, 3-0 kind of signifies what we've seen. It's like the early rounds of a boxing
game. I think so, especially the defenses. You know, both offenses respect what the defenses can do. Both coaches have said the same thing to us. We want to avoid the negative plays because that kind of juices the defense, and you can see very conservative play calling to start the game.
3rd and 9. Corner blitz. Got it. Kenyon Drake has it. Goes left. Looks for a block. That will be close for the first down. I think he got it. And Drake holding his thigh.
This is one of those turnaround quick screens on 3rd and long. Remember the big screen that Alabama hit in that 21-21 Florida game? He took a shot right on that leg again, right, that he hurt before.
Well, that was an interesting little.
Might not be the same injury, but it looks like the same leg, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Ooh, he got bent.
Look at Trey Elston, number 7.
Oh, man, that was pretty graphic right there. That's this one he's not going to play from. That's a. That's a bet.
Well, the medical staff, trainers immediately out to help tend to Kenyon Drake. Well, medical staff is still out at the 40-yard line taking care of Kenyon Drake, injured on that last pass completion. And they were immediate in their reaction to the injury.
And the players on the field were reacting too. They saw it, you know, and probably maybe even heard this one because that's a lot of pain, you can tell. And you know, the way it was broken there, and he probably saw it himself, and it scares you. I've been on the field where guys have that happen, and it scares you. That was a great reaction from the Ole Miss players, too, saluting him.
Well, the Ole Miss reaction was immediate and empathetic. Tony Connor.
Yeah, if he made a hit, and Senquez Golson, number 21, ran away from it. Tony Connor ran away from it. They all knew how bad it was.
Well, you saw a thumbs up from Kenyon Drake, reminiscent for those of us who've been around a long time, when Wesley Britt, the offensive tackle, there's motion in the line. Wesley Britt injured similarly, and as he was carted off, gave a thumbs up to the Crimson Tide fans at Brian Denny. False start cost Alabama 5.
First and 15.
So far, very conservative play calling from Lane Kiffin. Still feeling them out. The safeties are staying very deep for Ole Miss. They're trying to keep it in front of them. They believe they can make Alabama go the long way.
There's play action. Sims dances to his left. Off balance, incomplete at the feet of Christian Jones, number 22.
There's Lane. Longtime veteran Dave Womack is matched up as defensive coordinator for Ole Miss. Dave is one of those vets in this game, 58 years old. He and John Chavis, who's also 58, and Ellis Johnson, defensive coordinator for Auburn, are the real veterans in this league, and they've really, as Dave visited with us yesterday, have seen it all.
Second down and 15. Yeldon, play action again. Sims lets it go. It's dropped. It looked like Cody Pruitt, the All-American, had both hands on it.
Well, I thought Brian Vogler ran a very lazy route here. When he turns around, he doesn't step back to the quarterback at all, and Cody Pruitt should have intercepted it. You called it right, Vern. That ball should have been caught and should have been a big play.
Third and 15.
You cannot against elite athletes, especially veteran elite athletes like Ole Miss, be lazy in your pass routes.
Amari Cooper is top of the screen. They're laying way back of it. Yeldon cuts it back up. He'll come up 3 yards short of the first down. C.J. Johnson. Well, Cody Pruitt, All-American last year, and somewhat outspoken.
Yeah, you know, it's one of those, everything gets heard nowadays. I think maybe the way Cody Pruitt would like to have come out, since we're better, they don't look as good.
Yeah.
You know, when you're not very good, Alabama looks really good. But Ole Miss now thinks they can compete. Now, can they beat them? That remains to be seen.
Fourth down two.
Excuse me, Vern. Alabama never goes down easy.
J.K. Scott is on the punt. Markell Pack is the deep man.
Yeah, that was conservative.
Certainly was. Ole Miss has it back. CBS Sports coverage of Home Depot SEC continues after this word from your local station. In 1969, as a matter of fact, 45 years ago tonight, these two teams met at Legion Field in Birmingham, one of TV's early primetime broadcasts. In what became a game for the ages, Archie Manning threw for 436 yards and ran for another 104, totaled 5 touchdowns. But it wasn't enough. Alabama, led by Scott Hunter, edged the Rebs 33-32, which is a nice way to lead to our duck question, the Aflac trivia question of the week: which player holds the record for total yards in an SEC game?
First and 10.
Archie Manning had it for a long, long time. I remember watching that game. The telecasters that night for ABC Sports were Chris Schenkel,
Bill Fleming,
and Bud Wilkinson.
Bud Wilkinson.
And I remember listening to Schenkel. I said, man, I'd love to do that someday.
Yeah. Now there are kids out there saying the same thing about you.
Uh-oh.
What a catch. Are they going to call offense? offensive interference on the play?
Laquan Treadwell.
Are they going to call it on Cyrus Jones?
Let's see.
That was a battle. Laquan went up and got it. 2013 number one rated recruit in the country.
Pass interference on the defense, number five. That penalty is declined. The result of the play is a first down.
You know, I think that's one Cyrus Jones, as Nick's clapping, you just got to live with. You got to be physical with that guy. Treadwell's one of the great receivers we have in college football. I mean, he's every bit of a much a weapon as Cooper is. And playing the wide this year, last year he played in the slot.
Wallace keeping all the way. Let's go back to the studio for a Ford update. Here's Adam Zucker.
All right, thanks, Vern. Only three teams left unbeaten in the Big 12, two of them facing each other. Bama fans know this guy. Oklahoma's Trevor Knight, first play of a drive to Sterling Shepard for 75 yards. They tie it up at TCU after trailing 14-0. Back to you, Vern.
All right, Adam, thank you. Here's the handoff, and that looked like a little bit of a mistake. DJ Petway got in the way.
You know what's interesting so far about this, in my opinion, is Ole Miss is really not going hurry up. Everyone anticipating this game, Hugh Freeze, one of the architects of the hurry up offense, everyone expected, since Alabama, quote unquote, supposedly struggled against the hurry up, everybody thought that they would see it. We talked to Hugh about it. He said, nah, I'm a little nervous hurry up against Alabama.
Wallace, good protection. It's knocked right back in his face by DJ Petway. Fourth down. And let's go down to Allen the fourth. Allen.
Thanks, Vern. The injury was so severe on the left leg that, you know, his left foot was pointing the complete opposite way. He's certainly not coming back into this one, but he is getting x-rays taken right now, and I'll let you know when I have more information on the specifics of the injury.
All right. That's Kenyon Drake, about whom we're speaking. Will Gleason is on to punt. Christian Jones is back to return for the Crimson Tide. Inside the 20 and down. Yards on the punt. 11:30 to go, first half. 3-0 Ole Miss. Doubleheader tomorrow, the NFL on CBS. Lead game early, Houston at Dallas. Three other games in that early slot: of Kansas City at San Francisco, and New York Jets are at San Diego. It's a doubleheader Sunday on CBS. It all begins with the NFL today, tomorrow at 12 noon, presented by Southwest Airlines. Game day in Oxford. Very few places quite like it.
It's fantastic.
Alabama trails by three. They have one missed field goal in the game. Derrick Henry, number 27. We talked about the Ole Miss defensive coordinator, Dave Womack.
You know, when I went out to practice Thursday, I was actually shocked. I've watched a lot of Thursday practices. It was shift and motion day. A lot of different formations for Alabama. This Ole Miss defense did not bust one assignment. They almost had a perfect day lining up against the different formations, and they're on track so far today in the game.
Derrick Henry, well, as with so many coordinators or assistant coaches, Dave Womack, a very lengthy itinerary. And I've interacted with him at South Carolina, at Arkansas, and here. He actually got out of coaching, he told us, for a couple of years, lives near Branson, Missouri. He fished for 120 days in 2 years. His wife said, that's too much. That's Chris Black who makes this catch, and that's good to move the chain.
This was a dangerous throw by Blake Sims. He looked left, wanted to go left, and then turned and fired the ball really without focusing in on the throw. That's very dangerous.
Drake, he's the biggest of the backs. Weighs in at 241 pounds.
Well, you just watch this game unfold. It's moving so slowly. Amari Cooper so far, 2 receptions for 3 yards. When is it going to be that play action bomb?
2 wides to the right, 1 to the left. Derrick Henry. Robert Kimdiche. Number 5 made the tackle. And number 1 recruit. That's just the volumes I think about.
Well, his brother was playing on the football team here too, Denzel. But you know, if you watch, Robert doesn't make a lot of plays, but he's a big impact player. You know, he reminds me of Marcel Darius, who used to play tackle in the same position for Alabama a few years ago.
3rd down, 1. Fowler is in as a fullback. He gets the block right, but it is stuffed. Marquise Haynes, number 27. 4th down.
Yeah, it's kind of amazing. Marquise Haynes, as you say, at number 27, is a true freshman taking on this play. Gets into the backfield right through the tackle that time, Austin Shepard. I mean, that short yardage offense, that is a problem if Alabama can't pick up those yards in this football game.
They lead the country in fewest 3 and outs. That was not a 3 and out, but they are stymied. Here's J.K. Scott, line drive. Looks like a pre-snap flag.
False start on the offense. The 5-yard penalty remains 4th down.
Felt like it took a long time to punt that ball, didn't it? It just, you know, the tempo of that punt, it just seemed to take a while on that one. Let's see later in the game if that doesn't become a problem.
Scott nice and high this time. And Markel Park, boy, he nailed that, didn't he?
Perfect ball. Outside the numbers, perfect punt.
Comes to rest at the 13. Marquise Haynes, number 27. What you mean, Marcus Haynes?
Adam Zucker in New York, coming up on the Geico Halftime Report. Spencer, Brian, and Coach Brett Bielema and I will get you caught up on all of today's action, including about 90 miles away from Oxford. Dak Prescott, 5 total touchdowns as Mississippi State runs away from A&M. Now back to Oxford.
All right, Adam, thank you. It's 3-0 here. Ole Miss trying to go 5-0. They're 4-0 for the first time in 44 years. What was going on back then? Oh, my gosh. Paul was quitting the Beatles. And other news at the time. The price of gas might get your attention, 35 cents a gallon. Freshman not eligible to play. And the 1970 Ole Miss football team, 4-0 that year. That fella in the middle is Archie Manning. Archie and Olivia, substantial part of the rich tradition and support, more significantly, over the years of this university. Here's Bo Wallace. Jordan Watkins is the running back now. Quick flip, near side. Gets a block on the edge. Cody Core, that's his 3rd catch today.
Well, Laquan Treadwell has been able to catch it, the nice pass, and on this one he gets the good block to really get the receiver out. Might have been a little hold there on Cyrus Jones, but he got away with it.
Yeah. Quickly on 1st down, Wallace slings it. That's a little too far left.
But as Hugh told Allie in the open, Bo, if it's not there, don't be worried about throwing it out of bounds. And going back to the tempo again, one of the reasons that Hugh told us, if you'd asked me 2 years ago, can you build a program around just tempo, I would have said yes, but now I don't think so, not in this league. He said, I'll give it to you as a tactic, but we've found that it produces too many negative plays, especially against elite competition. We won't use it that much in this game.
Here's a draw play, and it's Jordan Watkins. Wilkins coming around the left side. Well, the Wallace numbers today, 8 of 14 for 66 yards. Recall that he opened offensively with a quarterback draw.
And they have to be careful of how often they run their quarterback, because there is no experience behind Bo Wallace. Ryan Buchanan and Devontae Kincaid are both freshmen.
Third down, 4. Blitz. Wallace. Oh, he missed
you
it.
You could tell right from the start that Alabama did not react with that, and I'll bet Nick Saban was irate. They put a running back in motion, and Alabama starts looking at each other on what to do. Yeah, I could figure that out. And I guess it was Reggie Ragland. I'm betting on
that.
One guy goes in motion, and nobody knows what to do. And look at this. Inside, an easy completion, and Cody Core could have been a first down, and Bo missed him. Yeah, that was a misalignment, and yeah, who did you get yelled at more by, Nick or Kirby on that one?
Equal. Equal verbal abusers. Here's Wunderlich to punt. Fair catch. Oh, I thought he took a fair catch. He did not. Christian Jones tackled after a modest return of 4 yards. Well, let's cue the duck one more time with 7:11 to go in the second quarter. The answer, if you've been paying attention, I bet you got this. Johnny Manziel did it twice, once last year against Alabama, the year prior against Arkansas. Archie said, well, I held it for 43
yeah,
years.
Yeah, it's not bad. A record deadlock.
Pretty good.
Well, you know, I'll bet Alabama was a little bit stunned with that injury to Drake. Let's see if they now relax and try to play some offense the way they feel they can.
Sims got it. That's Chris Black, his second catch of the ball game.
That's that little bootleg package that Sims is so good at. Remember, defensive coordinator Momak said to us, yeah, Cooper's really, really good, but we must control Sims. Those little bootlegs are just really tough on a defense. We have to know where he is on every throw.
Blitz from the corner. They get by it. It's Yeldon. Hauled down from behind, just short of the 30-yard line. C.J. Johnson.
Yeah, I think this one might come back, because on the corner blitz that time, right into it. I think the receiver downfield.
Illegal block in the back. Number 42 on the offense. 10-yard penalty.
I think it was 45, Vern. Justin Ross Fowler, number 45. Fowler is the lead back, and he couldn't find anybody to block, so he turned around. Watch him. He gets downfield. He blocks him once, and then he blocks him again. Yep. He had him once. He probably didn't need to do it again.
Well, that negates a 25-yard run and a first down. Tack on 10. Third penalty against Alabama in the first half. Left side. Cooper. Third catch of the ball game. And let's once again go back to New York and check in with Adam Zucker.
All right, Vern, thank you. Alabama with some tough times getting off to a start on offense. Same for Florida State. Jameis Winston going in with about a minute to go in the first half. 13-3 the score. Knowles up on Wake Forest right now.
Yeldon sweep left, wide open. One man to beat. And he can't quite do it. That was Cody Pruitt. Got good position for the tackle, but that's a 23-yard gain.
Well, that time, Cam Robinson, the true freshman left tackle, just did his job. Hooked his man on the play. Great block by number 74 that time.
Sweep again, Derrick Henry.
And it really seems so reminiscent, you know, of how Alabama loves to run the ball left. Remember that SEC championship game against Georgia when they ran it left and left and left? Now you put a freshman there, they keep doing the same thing.
That's Cam Robinson, number 74, the true freshman. They'll throw it this time left, and it's Amari Cooper. That's his fourth catch. He's averaging little over 10 per game.
This is a great read by Blake Sims. He studied his game plan. He saw the high safety very deep, so he knew he had one-on-one to the left side, and he went right to it. When he saw that one safety back there, he knew what he had.
They go left again. Yeldon spilled at the 11. Sir'Darrius Bryant with the tackle, number 14. Let's check the Alabama Verizon Red Zone stats for the year. 24 times inside the 20, 16 touchdowns. And that's a little above the national average. Second down, 6. Do you detect a trend?
Why not?
My gracious.
I mean, if Lane calls one to the right, I think Nick will walk over and slap him, don't you?
That's Jalston Fowler with the block. Yeldon with another game. 9 carries, 69 yards for T.J. Yeldon. Up the middle this time. And it's Yeldon again, his 10th carry.
And this is always the fear. You know, coming into this game, Ole Miss thought, okay, this is not the same Alabama team. They're not going to pound it on us. We're going to keep our safeties back, but look what happens.
And into the corner. Out of bounds. Amari Cooper.
Kadarius Webster, number 15, a true freshman. And the reason they put him in the game is he's 5'11 instead of 5'8. And he's in the game for this reason right here. Oh, I think he got his foot down.
Do you really?
I thought he got his toe. Let's see if they don't bring this and take a look at it.
I believe they. Not so far.
His heel now was his toe down first, but his heel came down. Ooh, very close.
Out of bounds.
Yep.
No review. Third and goal. Yelled it.
Ooh, they went right.
They'll spot it short.
They went right, and then they didn't get anything.
Fourth down.
Will they just sneak it? Will they sneak it? Remember, Blake Sims was a running back.
Play action.
Keeps it.
Play action.
Keeps
Sims
it.
Strolls in. Fool me once. Don't fool me twice.
Well, remember the last time Blake Sims played in this stadium, he was a running back. And on fourth down, they gave it to him. That was a power drive. 12 plays, 8 of them were runs, and even the bootleg pass, a couple quick screens, that was all power.
Adam Griffith will attempt the extra point. Up and good.
Fourth and inches, would they sneak it? This time they say no. Cody Pruitt comes in on too sharp of an angle from the right side, doesn't know who he has in the ball, and it's a walk-in.
Blake Sims. Touchdown, Alabama, they lead 7-3. Here in Oxford, Mississippi. We're on the campus of Ole Miss. The Geico Halftime Report coming up with Adam, Brian, Spencer, and Coach Bielma in the studio today. Arkansas acquitting themselves so well last week despite losing in overtime to Texas A&M. That's only the third touchdown given up this year by the Rebels. Jalen Walton and Mark Dobson are deep. And Adam Griffith will kick off.
Another weak kickoff.
Jalen Walton. Jalen Walton knocked out of bounds up near the 40 by Adam Griffin.
Well, as you know, most college football teams are putting that kickoff at least to the goal line so far. Alabama twice has not gotten that ball even past the 10-yard line. Bounced about the 12-yard line, and again, that coverage is misaligned and great field position. Remember, Ole Miss won the toss and took the ball. So as they go into the second half, Alabama will start with the ball in the second half. An important drive for them. They can't have a three and out.
First down, 10. They try the sweep, now the flea flicker. Nobody open. He's still upright, but only for about an extra 2 seconds.
How good a defense is that for Alabama? That's one of those plays that you think you're going to get something out of, and Alabama just looked at their assignments, played their assignments. Every receiver was covered. They even had the quarterback coming out of the backfield, and it could have been a loss of 10 if not for a great job by Treadwell that time.
Loss of 3 as it stands. That's Jalen Walton, number 6.
A big play for Ole Miss right here.
2:45 to go first half.
Ole Miss substitutes. Alabama will have now an opportunity to put their substituted defense in the game. I don't think tempo has been one play in this football.
Right, huh? Not at all. Wallace rolls out. Ducks.
Don't be surprised if Alabama doesn't take a timeout right now.
Xavier Dixon, number 47.
They've got all three. They did not trust their pass protection. They rolled out, and when you roll out, it really cuts that field down, and there was no one to throw the ball to.
Jonathan Allen was first there. Ole Miss is now 1 of 7 on third downs.
Wow. Wow.
2 minutes to go, first half.
What was the scouting report from Ole Miss and Hugh Freeze? He said, as a group, this is the best pass rushing group he's seen at Alabama. Maybe not a star, but all of them can rush the pass.
Gleason runs away from it wisely, or rather Gleason kicked it, and Christian Jones ran away from it. Thursday, your football week starts here when the Colts and the Texans collide. Another big-time matchup in primetime Thursday Night Football on NFL Network and CBS. Do you think Jim Nance, Phil Simms, Tracy Wolfson are hoping for a close game?
Well, they're going to get a good game here. I mean, anybody doesn't want to watch Andrew Luck play football. It's one of the, and J.J. obviously as well. But coming back with this one with, what, minute 44 to go, Alabama will probably start off slow. They like to screen and draw early on these two-minute drives.
Derrick Henry gets the handoff and is dragged down by Isaac Gross, number 94.
What's been a big part of this football game for Alabama is in the last 2 years, Ole Miss's defensive front got a tackle for a loss on 1 out of every 5 plays. So far in this game, they've not been doing that. No big bad plays for Alabama.
Left side again. This has become a monotonous theme for the Alabama running game.
I'm sure Hugh Freeze is going to take a timeout here, and he did.
So that is the second timeout used by the Rebels with 1:08 remaining in the first half. 3rd and 7 when we come back. 7-3 Alabama Crimson Tide lead. One of their leading receivers, DeAndre White, having a problem with an injury. This was DeAndre in the pregame warmups, limping a little bit. Let's check in with Allie LaForce.
Thanks, Vern. I was told that he is purposely being used sparingly. They knew coming into the game that he had the foot injury, so they didn't want to overexpose it. There has not been an additional injury. They are simply choosing to use him at specific times to keep the injury from getting any worse.
As a decoy in this game, interesting call here. You don't want a catastrophic play if you're Alabama. Do they run it and force the last timeout, or do they go to their big number nine and try to get a play?
And DeAndre White is on the field in the slot.
Yeah, they run it.
Oh. Isaac Gross cut through.
Yeah, Isaac Gross was all over the field when you, in the 2012 game, he had a big game, and he's had in the backfield two big plays, and this time, that's almost a busted assignment that time by Ryan Kelly. He was going to pass off Gross, and by the time he turned around, it was too late.
And Ole Miss uses its final timeout, stops the clock with 63 seconds to go, and they should get this in pretty good field position. And during the commercial, there we are, Katy Perry.
To her own song.
Of course, you recognize the song.
Go ahead, Vern, you have it.
Firework,
oh, of course.
Firework,
of course.
Yes.
Is that on your workout?
Yeah, it's on my podcast. Yeah,
podcast.
On my iPod. Whatever it is.
Good, close enough. Well, this punt situation, remember the last one was great, but I said he's a little slow. They're going for the return. Oh, another great one.
Oh, brother.
Wow. Well, that's basically the end of the half right there.
J.K. Scott. Well, his previous best was 62. Put that one in the books is 65 yards with no return.
Yeah, now it's going to be very dangerous. Remember, as much as Bo may bristle at the good Bo, bad Bo, Hugh Freeze, his play callers, heard it too and probably seen it. I'd be very surprised if he allows Bo to make a mistake here at the end of the half. Remember, one last thing, Alabama looking up there with those three yellows has all three timeouts, so they could force one more punt here.
51 seconds remaining. Yep. Keep it conservative.
Beginning of that, he almost got a face mask on the play. I really did. I thought Cyrus Jones hit the face mask and almost kind of lost the concentration. Let's see it right here. Oh, yes. He did turn his head a bit, lost concentration that time by Mathers, and a catastrophic play. And the crowd just saw the replay right there. Yes, that could have been called and should have been called.
It certainly appeared.
You know, we said catastrophic mistake by Alabama.
Right.
Catastrophic mistake by Ole Miss. It was a catastrophic mistake by the official.
It certainly appeared to be a face mask. Cyrus Jones on Mathers. There was no flag. And then a fortunate bounce of the ball right up into the arms of Cyrus Jones. And like that, it's 14-3. On your left, Itavius Mathers, who was the running back, number 5. On your right, Cyrus Jones, cornerback, number 5. And what appeared to both Gary and me as a face mask on the run, but not called. And the result, a fumble and a 13-yard scoot for the touchdown that extends Alabama's lead to 14-3. Adam Griffith will kick off, squibs it, taken at the 28-yard line.
Took a knee on play to go back.
Well, now we got some extracurricular stuff going on.
Nothing's going to happen there. That last play, so devastating for Ole Miss. Great play by Cyrus Jones. He did get his hand at the... I think when he turned the helmet, it actually turns the football. Watch this. When he turns the helmet, it turns the football to him and exposes it. That's why the ball was actually open right there.
Mm-hmm.
That's one somebody would have liked to head back with the striped shirts. They're still watching it on the big screen here.
Yeah.
It's not as festive as it was an hour ago, is it?
Not at all. Play action. Wallace. Jalen Walton dropped that one. Could have been a first down, and he could have cleared the clock.
Well, let's talk about Ole Miss right now. As the official's looking right at it, doesn't make the call. Vern, remember what you opened up me saying that Ole Miss was said we're ready to compete.
Right.
Not win, compete. Well, part of competing is fighting through adversity. We're going to see how tough they are mentally now in this football game. There's a lot of time left. They've got a bad call against them. Now we'll see what they're made of.
Hugh Freeze, 45 years of age, was the head coach at Arkansas State. Search committee, two people. Most importantly, Archie Manning was put in charge of selecting the new head coach at Ole Miss, and they chose Freeze, and they chose well. Well, interesting.
Well, it was so rude down there. The cameraman was right in that official's face, 2 inches away on the field. They should throw that cameraman out of this park.
I saw that. Let's go down to Allie, who is with Hugh Freeze.
Coach, that last fumble really changed the momentum of this game. How do you address it at halftime?
Play the next play. You know, you got to take care of the ball, and thought we had a face mask on it, but we didn't take care of the ball, and it certainly it hurt, you know. Our defense is fighting our guts out, and we're not converting on third down at all to stay on the field. They're on the field too long.
You held Alabama's offense to just 7 points. What's working defensively?
Well, I think we're pretty good, you know, and we're mixing it up, and defensive front's playing good. We got to figure out that the stretch play that they're running to the boundary, but defense has played well. That's not the issue right now. It's us converting on third down to keep them off the field.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Let me follow up one more time on that. It was a photographer on the field, not one of our guys, snapping shots 6 inches away from that. Listen, we all make mistakes in the world. That guy had no right to be going on that field and doing. Here it is, right here. Look at that.
Yeah, circling area.
That is just uncalled for, and they need more security on the field. That's everybody can be criticized. Everybody makes mistakes, but that's not right.
And then the fellow in the red shirt turned and followed the official toward the end zone tunnel. We've reached halftime. Let's go to Adam Zucker in our New York studio.
All right, thanks, Vern. Only authorized cameras in here. Coming up on the Geico Halftime Report, Spencer, Brian, and I will tell you about Mississippi State in its statement game. Plus, Arkansas head coach Brett Bielema joins us after this word from your local station.
We welcome you back to Oxford, Mississippi, Vaught Hemingway Stadium on the campus at Ole Miss. Now let's go inside the headset powered by AT&T, the official sponsor of the SEC. Here's Allie LaForce.
Thanks, Vern. I got a chance to talk to Nick Saban heading out of halftime. He said the big thing is we have to execute better offensively. We have drop balls. We have penalties. We're shooting ourselves in the foot. I asked him for an update on Kenyon Drake after we saw him suffer that gruesome injury. He said he's definitely out, but I have not gotten any further information onto the specifics of the injury. Now, when you do type in Kenyon Drake's name on Twitter, there have been several former athletes reaching out, showing support. One of them is former Redskins quarterback Joe Theismann, who suffered a similar gruesome injury 30 years ago. Others to reach out are former Alabama players Mark Ingram and Greg McElroy. Those are few of many who are showing their support for Drake.
right, Allie, thank you. If you'll recall, Ole Miss won the toss. To open the game, they took the ball. So Alabama will receive it now. Gary Wunderlich will kick it deep. Christian Jones is one of those back to return the kick. That's a good one. Through the end zone, out the other end. Vern Lundquist, Gary Danielson, Allie LaForce. Certain resilience on the part of Alabama, but Ole Miss got a tough break. How do they get back?
Yeah, Alabama's Alabama. You know what they're going to do. Ole Miss has got to just overlook it. They got a bad break. It's happened before in sports. It happened today. Listen, they need offense. 2 years ago, they got 218 yards. Last year against Alabama, 205. First half, 105 yards. Mm-hmm. I mean, what are you going to expect? A turnover or something? You got to produce some offense, or it's going to be hard to beat Alabama. We talked about quarterbacks playing at a very high level to beat Alabama. You know, Bo's done all right. He hasn't been asked to do a lot, but not enough offense to beat a good football team.
In the meantime, their defense opens on the field. This one's caught by O.J. Howard, the tight end, his second catch of the game.
I mean, not only that, but, you know, they had other opportunities. They had a dropped interception. They had an interception in plus territory. They missed a, you know, there's just opportunities to put a good team in trouble, and they haven't done it.
Cooper.
Yeah, see what I'm talking about? These defensive backs and linebackers for Ole Miss, they're so quick and so tough to block. Trey Elston, look how quick that is coming up there. Is that Hilton, number 28 that time? They are just so quick, and Elston finishes it off.
Yep. That's five catches for Cooper, but a very modest yardage figure, only 23.
Remember last time they ran right, and it was stuffed. Let's see which way they go this time.
Quarterback keeper. Well, let's see where the spot is.
Well, if he touches the line because it was a touchback, it's a first down.
Yep. Blocks of Ari Quanjo and Ryan Kelly. Dakota Ball is in as a tight end, top of the screen, number 94. Vogler is tight to the right. Up the middle, more or less. TJ Yeldon, Gary, take us through first half trends.
Well, it's about what we talked about. Both teams playing it close to the vest in this football game. Blake Sims had one dropped interception. Bo Wallace, both quarterbacks doing about the same in the football game. And of course, the one big play, I guess you could talk about, you know, I mean, the ball was still fumbled, even though it should have been a face mask hole. It doesn't mean you have to fumble the ball, but, you know, that would have been one that I think all of us watching the game, except for the true Alabama fans, would have liked to see him called properly.
Yes. Second down and five. Yeldon.
Yeah, he's something, isn't he?
Oh.
I remember, it was like, I think it was 2 years ago. I think we were getting ready to do that primetime game with LSU, and John Chavis was talking about the great backs. They had Eddie Lacy and Trent Richardson, and he goes, you know, the guy that really sparks them is T.J. Yeldon. I think that's how it happened. I do remember him picking out T.J. Yeldon as a future star. Remember
well,
that?
And you remember at the end of the game,
yep,
Karen found Yeldon with the screen pass for the game winner. Absolutely.
That game kind of was a little bit like this game. LSU came back in the second half and evened out the game, and then Alabama won late.
Here's Yeldon again. He has been the workhorse here in this ball game. That's his 14th carry for 94 yards.
Well, it is interesting. Alabama in the first four games went the no huddle. People were asking me, even, you know, in the pregame on our own show, will they go no huddle? I think Brett Bielema asked me, do you think that Alabama will still go up tempo? And I said, if they're comfortable, if it's a close game, they're going to go back to what they do. And this is what they do. Whether they huddle or don't huddle, they like to run the ball. And they like to run it between the tackles.
Derrick Henry, all 241 pounds of him. And that's another first down at the 38-yard line.
The offensive line, which a lot of people said have Nacho that time, while Leon Brown, number 72, that position that was talked about at right guard, whether Dominic Jackson, number 76, was going to see some playing time. Leon Brown held onto the job and that time just crushed his opponent.
Another opening series first down as we begin the third quarter here.
And Ole Miss has not crowded the box yet. They're still playing safe back there with two safeties.
Three down. Left side again. Henry puts it back. Breaks a tackle. And gets an additional 3 yards. Second down, 5. Justin Fowler, the fullback, over there just off the tight end to the left. Play clock at 9, still plenty of time. Sims goes left, diving try incomplete.
Well, if you look at the strategy so far in this game, I mean, it's either run left and cut back, or a little bit of run right. Well, this is a stop, a must stop for this Ole Miss defense. It'll be over a 50-yard field goal from here. The defense has to get them back in the football game, and this crowd isn't in the game yet either.
No, you're right. Third down, 5. Blitz. Sims caught. First down. Amari Cooper.
This might have been the first pass play ever put in football. Vern, you did this one.
I did.
Go down and button hook. Remember the button hook? And the ball was thrown perfectly. Go pass 1 yard. And again, that's Chris Carter right there. And I know he schooled him, but that's exactly how Chris Carter used to do it. Go a half yard past the post, throw it anywhere in there, and he'll catch it for a first down.
Just a footnote, I remember when Walter Camp called that.
That's the button hook.
First time in 10. Sims.
Not a good idea.
Whoa. Sir Darius Bryant was the first one there, number 14. And then Cody Pruitt wrapped it up.
Yeah, this defense is still fast, still aggressive, and they make up space. You cannot do that, reverse your field against this defense. They're as good as there is closing up that empty space.
Yeldon leaves the field. Cooper goes top of the screen. Derrick Henry is on as the running back. It's the 12th play of the drive, and DeAndre White is back on the field. Sims with a lot of time, but good coverage. Let's it go. O.J. Howard can't hang on.
I don't know if it was broken up or not, but he's already got one drop in the game, and I'm sure that's the drop that Nick Saban was referring to when he talked to Allie at halftime. And now you got to just have to believe that Lane Kiffin's calling a play here for a field goal.
Third down passing. Excuse me.
Nope, you got it right there, Vern.
Look at Sims' numbers for the year. They've been gaudy.
And he's had one drop for a first down in this game.
Yes.
Remember, it'd be 47 yards from here.
Cooper, top of the screen.
He tried that screen pass and was covered.
Out of bounds. That may have taken him out of field goal range.
They tried that same middle screen pass that time, and it was defended very well by Ole Miss. That's two plays he just had. Two plays, you cost me a field goal. If it's not there, throw it away. He lost yardage on first down, and he lost yardage on third down. You saw Nick go, two plays. That's the type of game management that can really get you in trouble.
Well, they will try the field goal. Adam Griffith, you were introduced to him with 1 second left in the Iron Bowl when he missed from 57. This is from 51. And he pulled it badly to the left.
Yeah, Now it's time for Ole Miss to make a run at this.
That one quacked on its way left. Now, this reminds me of the old show, You Be the Judge. We got a doubleheader next Saturday afternoon.
There you go.
We'll be at one of these places, but selections not yet made. The features: Alabama at Arkansas, Auburn at Mississippi State, LSU at Florida, Georgia at Missouri, or Ole Miss at Texas A&M.
I don't think we're going to be at Texas A&M.
You don't?
No. I'm gonna eliminate one just because I can.
First and 10.
Because you
I
know
have no power, but if no. I don't think we're gonna be there. That's
but
my
you,
prediction.
You know people.
Yeah. That.
Wallace being chased. Xavier Dixon chased him out of bounds.
How solid. I mean, Alabama has yet to, they've had that one mistake on the motion.
Mm-hmm.
Remember when Bo missed the guy, I think it was Core over the middle on that one, Cody Core, number 88. Otherwise, they have not had a missed assignment, an obvious missed assignment in the game.
Second down 12, loss of two for Bo Willis. Deep.
This used to be C.J. Mosley, but the linebacker is going to try to go deep with the tight end on the seam. And this time, it's not handled as well by Trey DePriest. That is a tough position to play. They ask a lot of that middle linebacker in this Alabama defense, and DePriest was not up for it on that one. A perfect throw, though.
Quarterback draw, Wallace goes right, gets four or five.
It's a version of their combo pass defense. It's why they're so good at what they do, because they challenge their linebackers to match up vertically down the field. And on that one, Trey DePriest did not handle it.
And as a result, in part of that, because Bo Wallace found Ingram for a gain of 50 at second and 7. Laquon Treadwell, touchdown Ole Miss.
I'll tell you, Alabama does what they do. They challenge their corners. True freshman Tony Brown, one-on-one. Back shoulder throw, missed tackle, and a brilliant play, a great throw. Back-to-back big throws by Bo Wallace and, of course, the talent of Laquon Treadwell.
Extra point is up and good by Wunderlich. Think about this. Alabama just had the ball for 6.5 minutes, 14 plays. They come out of it with zilch.
Yep.
Ole Miss has the ball for 4 plays. They come out with 7. Treadwell from Wallace. And it's 14-10, Alabama. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by the Home Depot. USAA. DirecTV. And by Chick-fil-A. Yeah, before a crowd of 61,826, that's the fourth largest in school history, they erupted with applause after that touchdown pass. Don't forget, later in the game, the play of the game presented by Napa Auto Parts. Now the crowd's into it.
I don't blame them. I mean, you know, as we've talked about a lot, Alabama does what they do. They're going to match up man-to-man, and if you can make a perfect throw, you're going to beat them. And on that one, a brilliant football player, Treadwell, beat a young football player. It was a great throw, and they out-executed at Alabama on back-to-back passing plays.
At the goal line, Christian Jones. very far. Wow.
They're diving in on that football, Vern. Let's see if this thing might have come out.
C.J. Moore was the first one there, number 26.
You can see the reaction to the players.
Yeah. Alabama's ball, but there's an Ole Miss player hanging on to it. There, it's out.
The ball's out. It's not going to change. Officials on the field call it Alabama. Ball's out. It's before his knee was down. And he must have scooped it back in. Because I know an Ole Miss player came out of it with the football.
Yes, he did.
Right now, Hugh Freeze is asking it whether it's reviewable or not.
He's still asking, and he's not getting a positive answer.
What I think he wants to know is, was the runner called down, or was it called that Alabama recovered the football?
Hugh Freeze is down at the 20-yard line. Here is the snap. It's Derrick Henry out to the 20. Now Freeze is out on the field.
Yeah, well, now it's too late.
Yep.
The only thing he'd be doing now is trying to get the next call, because he's not going to get the last one.
A confirmation from the field that the ruling was an Alabama recovery.
Right, because if it wasn't, it would have been reviewed, and that ball was out before his knee went down.
Second down, 4. Cooper all by himself, top of the screen. Up the middle.
Pressed that hole so well. He trusted it. As you look at the second half, just look back in this full game. Vern talked about the drives that have happened in this football game for Alabama. They've had a missed field goal with 14 plays and a missed field goal with 9 plays. 23 plays of their offense. No points. Unfortunately, plays don't count. Scores count.
Yep. First down, 10.
A lot of help on Cooper. Always help. They have a sign on the field, does Ole Miss, whether Cooper's in the game or not.
Deep down the middle. Wide open. O.J. Howard. Caught from behind, but inside the 20.
Great discipline by Blake Sims. He saw the tilt to Cooper. He looked left and came back. See the tilt over here to number 9? He knows that he's going to get this guy down the seam. Everybody's going to the left. Cody Pruitt is stuck in the middle of the field because of Blake's eyes. Wonderful job by Blake Sims that time.
They'll keep it on the ground. Here's Derrick Henry. Down near the 15-yard line.
If O.J. Howard would have dropped that one, all those people that were calling in the Knicks radio show would have called in and apologized. Remember, for 3 weeks, is why isn't O.J. getting the football? Well, he needed to catch that one.
Well, he went 3 games without a catch. He caught a couple, and he dropped a couple in this one.
Henry. Great, great defense.
Flag down.
Going to get a hold on the play, yeah, as well. Trey Elston, number 7, just busted into the backfield.
Holding on the offense, number 88. That penalty is declined. Third down.
And another player is down. It's Ryan Kelly, the center.
Yeah. And we saw the effects of Ryan, of a center going out of the game in the Arkansas-Texas A&M game. How late in that game a fumbled snap.
Kelly, the young man from suburban Cincinnati. Senior on this offensive line. Time is called. We'll be right back. Ryan Kelly walked off without assistance, but headed immediately to the locker room. And so the backup center, Bradley Bozeman, a redshirt freshman, number 75, out of Roanoke, Virginia, is on the field. Third down and 15.
Just get the feeling that Alabama's calling plays again, worrying about their kicker. Nick's probably turning around and is going, when is this going to stop? I've been doing this for 2 years. Well, that was illegal
motion.
Procedure.
Yeah, right, yeah. Tackle moved.
Yep.
False start on the offense, number 72.
Make it the guard, Leon Brown.
Well, you know, Alabama had done a good job of staying away from the negative plays in this game. But in the last two drives, two negative plays by Blake Sims, another negative play right there on the one they took, declined the holding, and now a penalty. Continuing to make the field goal tougher and tougher.
Third and 20. DeAndre White, Amari Cooper, both to the right side. Sims slips. And Derrick Henry is brought down. They're going to bring Adam Griffith on, young man whom we have told you grew up in Poland. Yep, there we go. There's the first miss. And here is the second. That second one was hooked badly. This from 44.
Yeah, there was 46 and 51. I bet his heart is beating now.
That looks good. That is good. Yeah, I agree with you. Adam Griffith, the adopted son of Tom and Michelle Griffith, math teachers in Calhoun. Nick Saban finally gets to applaud a kicker. All right, Adam, thank you. 17-10 here. Next Saturday is Super Social Saturday. All day on CBS Sports. Follow ATCBS Sports on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram to learn how you can participate. I knew I'd screw that up. It's at CBS Sports.
I got no help for you.
You know, I'm a big Twitter guy. You know
exactly.
That. But that's only when I'm not busy on Facebook or Instagram.
Well, someone's going to be busy with this Ole Miss offense right now because they show that they're willing to throw the ball, and Bo Wallace is coming out of his shell here.
Mark Dotson. And Bo Wallace for the day. Long game, 50 yards. He found his tight end, Evan Ingram. First half, 8 of 16. The last drive, 2 of 2.
Yeah, two perfect throws.
First down, 10. Ole Miss trailing by 7. Left side, Jalen Walton.
Vern, early in this game, we talked about that you better bring your good quarterback to beat Alabama. And look at some of the games these quarterbacks have had against Alabama. Tebow, Newton, Manziel, Nick Marshall, Trevor Knight in the bowl game last year. They have brought their A game to beat this defense.
Late handoff up the middle it goes, Jalen Walton.
You got to be balanced. These teams have all, except for Trevor, have all run the ball more than they've thrown the ball in these SEC games. Surprisingly, even Johnny Manziel and A&M, when they beat him in 2012, threw the ball significantly more than they passed the ball, but they passed the ball effectively. That's the key. Remember Cam Newton's second half of that game? Remember Steven Garcia? And, of course, the fourth quarter of Tim Tebow.
And so here is the challenge for Bo Wallace.
Called play.
Yes, it was. Slides down in front of Nick Perry. Aaron Morris got the key block then. Number 72, the left guard.
Yep.
Oh, did he ever.
Yep. Run all the way. And
Wallace has now rushed it 8 times for 31 yards. He picks up a first down, 10. Ooh, Was that tipped?
I believe
just
it was. I think Trey Dupriest got his hand on it. You know, there were rumors a year ago in Tuscaloosa that Alabama had a handle on the hand signals coming from the Ole Miss team. In this game, they're using four signs and three. No, they're using five signs and three different people signaling in the plays. I think they're safe.
I favor the trumpet.
Same play.
Treadwell, Laquon Treadwell, one of the stellar recruits 2 years ago. There were four starters off that class of 2013 that have really contributed significantly to Ole Miss. Third down, one. Trailing by seven.
They got the big quarterback in, don't they?
Jeremy Liggins, yep. The tight end, is the Wildcat. He'll keep it. 6'3", 296 pounds. That's his 11th carry of the year.
Yeah, with the expanded training table, I'm saying he's over 300. Since they've been able to spend more money this year.
First down, 10. That is their heavy formation. You see the total weight, north of 3,000 pounds. First down, 10. Again, looks designed.
Boy, Ragland that time. Reggie Ragland read that one and blew it up.
He stopped immediately by number 19, Reggie Ragland.
Coming from the left side of your screen. I don't even know if it was called a run blitz, but he got there that time before the quarterback even had a chance to get started. Another negative play in this football game, that time by Alabama.
That is the eighth tackle for loss in the ball game. Drills it, completes it, Vince Sanders.
So this will be the third time in this drive that Ole Miss will need to convert a third down play.
Third down, four. Could be the final play of the third quarter. They load them up. They've got three wideouts to the left side, one to the right.
See, again, not the use of tempo, only to freeze Alabama and make the call on the sideline. They just felt that they got, scouting themselves, too many negative plays going fast.
That one's tipped as well. It'll be fourth and four.
Twice they tried to establish what the defense was. And on the third one, it was batted away by Jaron Reed, number 90.
And so fourth down.
He looked huge there, didn't he? Junior college transfer. And again, as a group, the coaches I've talked to feel that this Alabama front four is a better pass rushing unit than they've seen in a while.
Rugby style punt. Fair catch called and taken at the 11-yard line. That's Christian Jones, number 22. 36-yard punt, very effective. And that is the end of the third quarter. Our score is 17-10. We'll return to Oxford right after this word from your local station. So we welcome you back to Oxford, Mississippi. Vaught Hemingway Stadium on the campus of Ole Miss. Fourth quarter, Vern Lundquist, Gary Danielson, Allie LaForce, and our entire crew enjoying our visit to Oxford. We don't get here all that often, but they have given us a wonderful afternoon, wonderful experience. 17-10, first down 10, Alabama with a first down at their own 11-yard line. Play action, Sims goes back. Looks deep right side, and that one is going to be
incomplete.
Incomplete. Well, two undefeated teams, 4-0. We were hoping for a close game. We've gotten one. Do you think this is about what these teams expect?
I'm sure of it. You know, we started off the game talking about the theme all week from here at Ole Miss. We want to compete. We don't expect we're going to walk out there and win. We just want to prove we can compete and earn the game. I think Alabama's happy with Blake Sims. He's gone on the road and done a good job. No big mistake. There's only been one outlier play in the game, and that was the fumble for the touchdown. Besides that, it's an even football game.
And that is the difference in the game right now.
Yeah, and the
Blake
Sims, the new center did not center.
Yep.
That's all he could do. He yelled, he jumped, he lifted his foot. And we talked about it. We saw the problem in the Arkansas game against Texas A&M. And this time, Bozeman, number 75, Bradley Bozeman, will not react. He's ready. Give me the ball. 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 He's calling out assignments, and he doesn't see the quarterback.
And they did get a timeout called.
It must have been from the bench then.
Okay.
It must have been from the bench. We were watching the play out there, and it had to be either Lane Kiffin or Nick Saban calling that play.
Now Red Lobster presents today's Scholar Athlete. D.T. Shackelford, 6 years a player. He had back-to-back ACL surgeries and missed 2 years. So given a medical redshirt, already has accomplished his master's degree in higher education. Early on said he wanted to be a high school principal. Now he's thinking more about sports administration.
Well, what a great career, huh, Vern? I mean, not only on the football field, but as you mentioned, off, he's the first member of his family to graduate from college.
Red Lobster's commitment to the investment of our future shown by donating $1,000 to the University of Mississippi's General Scholarship Fund. Second and 10. Fowler, number 45, the fullback. Sims deep right side, wide open is Cooper.
That is the first big play from the star receiver from the other team. Treadwell's made a few. This time, even though it's tilted coverage to Cooper, they decided to go to Cooper. What the heck? In a week, you can play him to a lot of great ones that have won Blitnikoff Awards. I mean, he's up there with the greats that have ever played college football. Sometimes you just got to throw him the ball. Forget the coverage and throw him the ball.
He now has 51 catches for the year. Yeldon is back on the field. He's number 4 behind Blake Sims. A couple.
Well, the truck did a good job here. They hear me talk about these Blitnikoff guys, and they throw up past Blitnikoffs, and there's the percentage of catches. Some of the greats have caught for their whole team, 33% by right. Now, that's on the whole year for the guys above.
Right.
And then Cooper's at, he's catching 43% of all the completions and 50% of all the touchdown passes. He's on his way to a Blitnikoff season.
Had a wonderful year last year, though he was hampered by a sore foot. Here's Yeldon, nice work, but it's going to bring up third down.
Let's talk about that Ole Miss defense again. Remember I said I went to practice and they didn't bust one assignment? I still say all the shifts and the motions and the overloaded plays and the unbalanced lines have not given the Ole Miss any trouble in this game yet.
Sims, that one's caught, and that should be enough for a first down.
That was a great catch because he had to go behind that time and reach back and catch it. And he knew he was going to get hit. Watch the ability to catch the ball and take the hit at the same time because he got labeled that time. I think it was Shackelford, wasn't it, that got him?
Well, 38? Mike Hilton.
Oh, was it Hilton? 28.
Okay. Yeah. But it is enough to move the chain, and it is the eighth catch for Amari Cooper in this ball game.
And that was an inaccurate throw that time, and Cooper bailed him out.
First and 10, Alabama leads by 7.
One wide receiver almost sends 3 Ole Miss defenders out with him.
And Yeldon tests left guard, left tackle. Cody Pruitt made the stop. Free safety.
See, here's where, you know how they do the box for the spread teams? Well, this is what you got to see if you're an Alabama play caller. One receiver, yet one, two, let's call this 2.5 guys out there, okay? That's a box that is comfortable for Alabama to run the ball against, and they should be successful against that box.
Yeldon has just gotten his 13th 100-yard-plus game. He's at 106.
Same look again. Look, two guys on Cooper.
Play clock.
Well, I think Alabama took timeout again.
Oh, they
too
did.
No flag on the play. Timeout. Alabama. That's their second charge timeout.
It feels like that Lane Kiffin and Nick Saban understand the importance of this drive. It's like they're all in on this drive right here. Yep, there's Nick running down there to call timeout.
Yep.
Right at the top of the screen.
And now it's time for our Geico game recap.
Not much scoring in the ballgame so far. The first field goal of the game. Wunderlich from 46 yards out. Ole Miss with a 3-0 edge. Finally, a 60-plus yard after the injury to Kenyon Drake, who left with what appeared to be a very serious leg injury. And then here was Blake Sims at the end of a lengthy drive. Play action rolled out to his left, strolled in, and Alabama had a 7-3 lead. This, the key play in the game. Mathers running right, may or may not have been a necktie. We thought it was face mask call, but the touchdown held. And Bo Wallace found Laquan Treadwell, 14-10. And then a moment ago, Adam Griffith from 44 yards out. And that's where we stand at 17-10, Crimson Tide. And halftime, one of the great players from the 80s here, Wesley Walls, on the right side, received his Hall of Fame plaque from Archie Manning. And his wife at the side, he'll receive the official tribute at the National Football Foundation dinner in New York City in early December. Sims chased. Oh, boy. That one's incomplete, but they could have had a huge loss.
That's what I was saying. Even though it's incomplete, it's like a 20-yard gain.
Yeah.
Because he got away from the safety blitz that time, coming right off the edge. Number 12, Tony Connor, I think it was.
It was.
Timed it perfectly. When Blake turned around on the bootleg, he was right there.
D.T. Shackelford.
Yep. He saw it all the way. He played the quarterback's eyes, and Alabama dodged one there. Second time in his football. That would obviously have been a tough catch. He actually overran it, didn't
yeah
he? But, man, that's a nightmare when you throw one like that. From personal experience, I can tell you.
Markell Pack will be back for Ole Miss. J.K. Scott will do the punting chores for the Crimson Tide.
And this needs to be careful not to jump off sides. It would be a first down. Another beauty.
Yes, it is.
Too
nice
on. Too beautiful.
By a yard. .11:31 to go. SEC West battle. Two undefeateds. Alabama leads by 7. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by Hyundai.
G3. And by Michelob Ultra.
Well, some 3 hours ago, we referred to this as a pivotal weekend in the SEC West. Mississippi State already a big winner over Texas A&M. Alabama leading Ole Miss by 7 here. And later tonight, LSU at Auburn. 3 huge games.
And, you know, even whoever wins this football game or loses this football game, there's still plenty of games in front of them. I mean, there's a lot going to happen in this league. One win and one loss doesn't get you in or out of it.
First down, 10 at the 20. Wallace, good time, left side. Ooh, Cyrus Jones, Laquan Treadwell battling.
Another back shoulder throw. When they see bump and run to the outside, they challenge, and what a nice play by Jones. He's had one pass interference, one no-call fumble touchdown, and a nice pass deflection right there.
Made the box score, didn't he?
Yep.
He sure did. Second down and 10.
You know, Ole Miss has only had 45 plays in this football game. Alabama 66. They need to make a couple first downs here.
They have only 4 in this half. And here's Wallace. He won't get it on this ball. That's Trey DePriest, number 33, first man there.
Right now, we talked about how they've had trouble running the ball the last 2 times. I mean, they're, what, 59, 60 yards again in this football game? They have not been able to find a consistent running game against Alabama for the 3rd consecutive game.
Wallace on 3rd down. He is the leading rusher, by the way, for Ole Miss with 31 yards. 3rd and 8. Got it. Cody Core, slot receiver.
I'll tell you, great protection that time and a well-designed route. The inside guy goes out, the outside guy goes in to hold the linebackers. Watch this nice design route. A little crisscross, release, and then right into the open territory. Beautiful.
Gain of 14, first down. 10:25 to go. Jalen Walton. Now let's go back to the studio for this Ford update.
Well, Vern, it is a week full of ranked teams going down. We didn't think it would be number 16 Wisconsin, but Northwestern has intercepted the Badgers 3 times. This one clutch by Godwin Igwe-Buike. And the Wildcats have a 20-7 lead. They could become a factor in the Big Ten West, Vern.
Yes, indeed, Adam. Here's Wallace. Pumps, driven out of bounds. And Adam, a quick update from Division 3.
Here we go.
Final score, Texas Lutheran 54, Howard Payne 27.
You know, instead of you giving money, they should give money to you.
Well, he's working on that. The Bulldogs are 5-0.
Here we go. Well, it's another 3rd down. Alabama had 3 of them on the last drive, converted the first 2. This is the 3rd time Ole Miss will have one of these in this drive.
3rd down, 9. 5 wide, 3 to the left, 2 to the right. Across the middle, caught. Markell Pack, number 11. Ryan Anderson got to the quarterback, but it's still a gain of 18.
Well, it was a great throw. I mean, this in pressure in Bo Wallace's face when he lets this one go, he gets hit by Ryan Anderson. I believe it was number 7 up front. But that reminded me of a throw that was made by Steven Garcia a few years ago when he engineered that upset at home when he was, I think, 20 for 24 or something like that. A gutsy throw by Bo Wallace right there.
Jordan Wilkins, number 22, with this carry.
I mean, this is really what you earn the confidence of your football team. You throw that ball, you let it go, and throw a perfect strike. And again, Alabama forces you to do that. They're going to play their coverages, and if you can throw it that well, you're going to complete the pass.
Second down, 10. Bunch receivers to the right side. Wallace, it took off on him, and it's blocked.
That's about the fourth big play that Ole Miss has not made. Yeah.
Evan Engram.
Bo has to calm his team down now. I don't know. It's one of these guys. Right
number
up the
17.
Middle. Yeah, I just met on the bunch.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, I didn't know where he was lined up. Matched up by Landon Collins, and that's a touchdown. That was great, Bo. Bad catch.
Third and 10.
Delay a game on the offense. A 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Bo Wallace just said there's no way. We took our normal time. Something had to happen to the play clock right there. There's no way, you know, and actually it caught the Ole Miss coaches flat-footed, too. They didn't sense it being too long either.
Mm-hmm. Let's it go.
Oh, what a play by Tony Brown.
Intended for Treadwell, and the true freshman knocked it away.
When Bo Wallace scrambled out, Laquan Treadwell broke off his route down the sideline, and Tony Brown reacts, turns around, and makes the athletic play. Treadwell does a good job realizing what's going to happen. He's open, puts his hand up, and watch Brown go, look for the ball, and make the play.
Will Gleason on to punt on fourth. Christian Jones.
That's going to be
out of bounds at the one.
I really don't like when these returners let these balls land like this, because that's exactly what can happen. You're better off catching this ball on the 10 than taking the chance that it goes out. So that ball landed about on the, it was about on the 8 or 9, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yep, I can't blame him on that one.
17-10. Well, for Ole Miss, in many ways, it's a case of what might have been.
It sure is. Just chances to win and upset a good football team. Opportunity to get an interception. Finish off the half 7-3. Critical mistake makes it 14-3. Chance to make an interception. That would have been a tough one. Nice play, but that's two, and then here's a touchdown. That's a touchdown drop. The last one, well, just as bad as the drop fumble right there, because that's 7 points. Now you got to watch two things. Bradley Bozeman, the redshirt freshman, number 75 at center, backed up. And the play calling down here, you got to get off your own end zone. Will they throw the ball? Those short little boots.
I don't know why, but this flashed just a moment ago. A.J. McCarron, Amari Cooper, 99 yards in the Iron Bowl. So Saban, that was A.J. McCarron, though. They'll keep it on the ground and pick up one. You remember that? It's almost forgotten in the Iron Bowl a year ago. Early in the fourth quarter in a tie game.
Oh, sure.
There's McCarron deep in the end zone. Amari Cooper. But that 99-yarder, all but forgotten in the final moments, and the end result of which Auburn won. How about
now,
this?
That's what I thought we'd get right there.
And
bad
Fowler,
yeah. Bad throw. Pulled the string that one time for Blake Sims. Didn't get his feet set. Had the fullback open. He felt the end zone. Look at his feet going backwards. He's jumping back as he throws the ball. If he delivers that, it'll be at least third and a yard or two.
And, of course, right behind the Alabama huddle, the Ole Miss student section. Third down and 9. Back up center. Alabama has not turned it over today. Yeldon Ooh, let's see what kind of spot he gets. Now,
I think it's going to be... Boy, you know, he made his last fake. It's going to be short.
Yep.
If he'd have just gone straight, I mean, it's easy to second guess this one. But he saw one more break, and that to his left. If he'd have just plowed up and taken it, see, that last cut might have, he might have been able to get across that line. Well-blocked play, well-run play, and Ole Miss gets out of there, stopping him with a three and out.
J.K. Scott is on the punt. He has one of 65 yards earlier in this ballgame. Markell Pack is near midfield for Ole Miss.
Delay a game. Delay a game. They saved it, Alabama's coaches, twice before, but not this time.
Now, Alabama with only one timeout left. Here's Scott, the freshman out of Denver. Backs up, makes sure that his right heel is well inside the end zone.
It's another one.
Boy, oh boy. All the way back to the 34. Pack. Taken down by Nick Perry.
What a punt, huh?
That's 60.
Yeah, what?
So he's got
punt.
Punts of 65 and 60. That was huge. But Ole Miss has the ball. All three timeouts left.
Adam Zucker in New York with an update on Oklahoma and TCU. After TCU took the lead on a pick six, Oklahoma blocks the extra point, and Zach Sanchez, who's from Fort Worth, returns it for 2 points. But the Sooners still trail TCU 37-33 early fourth quarter. Vern and Gary, back to you.
All right, Adam, thank you. And a score, the score here, 17-10. Alabama has won the last 10 between these two. And a note here, Alabama ranked number one in the coaches poll. Ole Miss has never defeated a top-ranked team. But before that, they've got to tie this one.
Yes, you know what seemed to have given Alabama a little problem? Let's see if they go to it. Those bunch formations, the last time they had the ball, they were putting three, sometimes four players together, and seemed to cause Alabama problems.
Handed off for three or four, Jalen Walton.
That was a good run.
Number six, absolutely. .608. Alabama, one timeout remaining. Ole Miss, all three. Under six. Got a man open. It's caught by Evan Engram, who dropped the touchdown catch. Last possession.
Yeah, got a great matchup that time. Well-designed play. He's got the tight end on the linebacker. Bo Wallace knows it right from the snap. Picks on the likely player and puts it right there, and it's caught.
Gain of 16, first down at the 34.
Here's the three receivers together again. It seems to be giving Alabama some problems over here. Three by one.
Stunts defensively for Alabama. He's got it wide open. Touchdown, Vic Sanders. And I think he beat the best. I think it was Landon Collins back there.
But it was also the formation.
Right.
They're having trouble matching up against the trips. They're playing off, and by the time they figure out who to cover, the guy seems to close the gap, and he's wide open.
Third touchdown of the year for Sanders, none bear. And a little flag here for unsportsmanlike. Oh,
that'll help field position,
boy.
Won't it?
unsportsmanlike conduct, number 17. That penalty has been forced on the kickoff. The touchdown is good.
Hugh Freeze says, what did he do?
Well, he dropped a touchdown, and then he caught a short pass, and then he had too much going on the sideline or on the field before he left, I assume. Bad penalty if it is, but boy, that formation in this second half has caused fits for Alabama.
Extra point, yeah. Good. We're tied. Take a look at the touchdown.
Vern said they beat the best. Landon Collins is the safety right here. Here's the touchdown. Just a little bit of hesitation. And as they play their combo routes, bam, he's by it. You take one step to the middle of the field, and all of a sudden it's a touchdown. The whole second half, they've been having trouble on this. Tony Brown gets beat inside, a well-run route, and again, it's not bad Bo, not good Bo, it was great Bo.
And great Bo reacts to this one.
And you know, we talked about how they would handle adversity in this game. We said in the open, they just wanted to show that they could compete. They caught a tough break at the end of the half, and they have finished this football game. No matter what it, how it ends up, they finished the game.
Now, let's see what the celebration penalty is.
Yeah, that's not allowed. Can't take your helmet off.
Wow. 5:29 to go. Notched at 17. Two undefeated teams. Just as a footnote, the last time Ole Miss was 5-0, 1962. They finished undefeated that year. Christian Jones. Ball's out. Ole Miss appears to have it.
Was number 11 makes the tackle on the play.
Channing Ward.
And then coming back, I think it was Kalen Moore that got the recovery on the
yes,
play.
Yes, that's it.
Wow.
Number 11 and number 8.
And the Alabama 31-yard line. First down.
And they were so close. Remember we showed that montage of plays, how close they were to getting an interception. And finally, the big play breaks Ole Miss's way.
.5:21 to go. Sweep right. Jalen Walton.
Oh, run.
Heck of an effort.
Jalen Walton can't be 200 pounds. And he just ran through tackles right there. The emotions of this football game had been earned back by Ole Miss. Play by play in the second half.
Second down and one. And a reminder that Alabama earlier used two timeouts to avoid delay of game calls. Yes.
Another back shoulder.
Laquan Treadwell. Ole Miss player down at the 15.
Can't do any better than this. This could have been a run or a pass. Bo Wallace sees the one-on-one coverage. He gives up on the running play and throws the ball to the wide receiver. The offensive line on that play had no idea that was going to be a pass. They were blocking a run play.
Aaron Morris is the injured Ole Miss offensive lineman, number 72. That was Tony Brown, the true freshman, number 2, victimized on that last play.
And I think true freshman Rod Taylor, number 73, will come in as his backup.
First and goal. Walton.
Well, at this point, you have to figure why you will not go back at least one time to Treadwell. You got to throw one up there, don't you?
Second and goal. There's Treadwell.
Second and goal.
Ball at the 8-yard line. Late add to the offensive line. Treadwell tight to the left. 10 seconds on the play clock.
They got the heavy quarterback in the game.
They do.
Will he throw one?
Jeremy Liggins, he'll run. He will not throw.
Boy, that
now
was,
then.
That was a big gamble. Taking your hot quarterback out of the game and try to gimmick the other team, and it did not work. They were going to throw from this formation for the first time. It was that little bootleg play where they slipped the fullback underneath and Alabama didn't go for it.
Now, if they don't get the touchdown, they're not exactly overwhelmed with assurance about their field goal kick.
He wants 1 second left and call a timeout.
Adam Fletcher, Andrew Fletcher, has missed once. He's the short field goal kicker. Wunderlich has hit from 46. He's the long field goal kicker. Third and goal. Time call. This one tied at 17, under 3 to go. And a reminder, stay tuned for the Dodge postgame show on CBS Sports when this one is in the books. 2:59 to go. And the Rebels trying to capitalize on a fumble recovery at the 31. They now have a third and goal at the 10. Sanders breaks to the left. Treadwell near side, late. Defensive adds for Alabama. There's the snap. Wallace into the end zone. Got him. Touchdown, Jalen Walton.
It's really the same confusion they've been having on the bunches, only this time Mathers was in the backfield, but it was the same confusion. They're going to slip right this guy out. Treadwell goes back and watch the confusion right here. It's like a bunch play. One step inside, and it's a touchdown. The bunch plays have really given Landon Collins problems in this game.
23-17. What do we got? Another celebration penalty?
They're going to review it.
Looks that way.
Yes. Let's see if he had it. I think his foot was down. His foot was down again.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, but might as well. It's a big touchdown. Take your time. I think he actually got 2 feet in on this one. One.
Two.
Does he have it? Does he have it? Does he control it? His knee comes down, then he hits the ground. Well, I think he has that one.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. It's a touchdown.
You know, this is why I just love sports. I mean, you just sit back, play the game, as some coaches call it, one play at a time. You take the bad plays, you move forward, as you know, Hugh was telling Allie. I mean, nothing you can do about it. Just go forward and play the rest of the game.
Gary Wunderlich will attempt the extra point. Ooh.
Oh,
doink.
And
no good.
I don't know if you were saying it in commercial or you were saying it live. There is a flag down.
Personal foul. Roughing the the kicker.
Oh, my.
Looked like it was Tony Brown, number two, who has been prominent in several of the last two or three plays.
Comes around the corner and just clips the kicker. Good call. You know, coming into this game, Alabama had 27 penalties, and their opponents only had 20. In this game, the more penalized football team has been Alabama again. Never in Nick Saban's career have the opponents had less penalties than his Alabama football team.
Andrew Fletcher this time. So interchangeable place kickers. Fletcher for the year is 21 of 21 coming in.
It's blocked. Oh, my goodness. And returnable.
Yes, indeed. Tony Brown blocked it. Well, now cinch it up.
Well, the ironies are just go one right after another here. You know, just think back to the penalty on Evan Engram, okay? He takes his helmet off and gets a penalty. One more look at this block here. Remember, he just had roughed the kicker before, but he does his job this time. I don't know if that was inside or was it Brown. I mean, I could have been inside that time by A'shaun Robinson, yep. Number 86. Yep. But just go back to the irony of this game. Engram gets the penalty by taking his helmet off, okay? So that moves the kick back 15 yards. Now remember, if the ball would have been 15 yards up further, the kickoff would have gone out of the end zone and the fumble would have never happened. So it's one of those things like good news, bad news. We'll see later.
And here is the touchdown.
Yeah, that led to that. Again, they have Alabama chasing themselves in fits with these kind of burst for offensive plays from either trips, or that time it was basically the same thing, trips coming from the back, split out from the backfield.
Wallace now 18 of 31, 251 yards, three touchdowns. 23-17. 2:54 to go. Alabama one timeout remaining. Wunderlich kickoff. Cyrus Jones is back, number five. He's chased and avoids a tackle. Got him up near the 28. Flag is down.
During the return, illegal block on the back on the return team, number 24. That's a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. It's first down.
Another penalty for Alabama.
That's on Geno Smith. Tonight on CBS begins with the new hit dramas Scorpion and Stalker, followed by a new edition of 48 Hours Tonight, only CBS.
Well, the strength of Ole Miss's football team is their front four pass rush. If you want to win a championship, it's set up for your defensive line to make the plays. For Alabama, now do you go to number nine? You have to assume that Ole Miss will take your best player away. Let's see what happens.
DeAndre White is top of the screen. Amari Cooper in the slot. First down 10, low snap. Sims picks it up, pumps, has to run, and does get out of bounds to stop the clock. 2:37 to go.
That's a gain of three. Second and seven.
Again, the backup center is Bradley Bozeman.
And he rolled the last one back there, that's for sure.
Yes, Cooper, he did.
Cooper on the bottom this time.
Sims caught to the 33-yard line. Christian, clock will stop after the gain of 17 while they reset the chains.
Just give some credit to that offensive line. They're going up against one of the most talented pass rushing defensive lines in college football. see if this guy, number 10, can put some pressure on him right there. C.J. Johnson.
Yeldon goes right. Surges out across the 40. Under two to go. Alabama can stop the clock once. Second and two.
And this player is down.
C.J. Jones, it appears. Johnson, yeah, rather.
I just circled him, too. I said, see if he can make a play. Play he made as he cramped up.
Yep.
Gets in on the field, but he's their quickest pass rusher from the outside.
1:44 remaining. And the clock mark ready for play. Yeldon, empty backfield. No snap again. Sims across the middle, caught by Cooper. Watch him weave. Watch him run.
That was nice by Blake Sims. He goes up in the pocket. He sees Cooper at the last second. Those real short throws are tough on wide receivers. The ball gets you real quick. Cooper makes a great adjustment on the catch and then uses his speed, we talked about it, to get outside the defense and make a huge play. And now the clock is zero factor in this game.
And that missed extra point looms huge. Caught by Yeldon, out of the tackle. To the 25, down to the 22. Cody Pruitt makes the stop.
Well, they tried to go to the T.J. Yeldon screen pass that won the LSU game. Remember that?
Mm-hmm. 1 minute to go.
Oh, a lot of space up at the top to just get a first down throw.
Blitz. Sims chased. Out of bounds, stops the clock, 44 seconds remaining.
A late flag.
Flag.
A late flag.
Holding. On the offense. Number 88. The 10-yard penalty. Repeat, second half.
That's O.J. Howard, the tight end.
Well, this is who they called it on. Keep your eye over there. He's got his hands up. He's okay, okay. When then Blake gets outside of the pocket, that's when it shows up. O.J. doesn't know where the quarterback is. And when the defensive lineman tries to release, he holds on to him too long. Good call.
Another low snap. Sims deep into the end zone. Double coverage. It is up for grabs. It might be. No, it's no. It's out of the end zone.
Well, this will be reviewed.
Cinquez Golson thought he had the interception.
Remember, he's 5'9". He went and got that.
Intended for O.J. Howard, who is 6'6".
He's got it. His foot comes down. Now, is he juggling it? He's got that football. Controls that football. That'll be reviewed. This could be an interception.
The previous play is under further review.
Absolutely. His left foot comes down. I think it's going to be called an interception.
Well, the call made by Tony Jocelyn, the back judge. Certainly, Golson thought he had the interception.
I think he has the interception, too. But the most important guy is whether the replay official Rocky Good thinks he has the interception. There's about 60,000 people that thinks he has the interception, I'll tell you that.
Yep.
He controls the football to me.
College rules, 1 foot in.
I'll tell you, the Ole Miss football team thinks they had it.
Now the coaching staff out trying to get the players back on the sidelines. There's control.
Oh, yeah.
Through the play.
He holds onto it with one hand. It's going to be an interception.
Here's the call.
After further review, the ball was intercepted in the end zone.
We started off the show, Vern, you said good bow, bad bow. And you know what it's going to be from now on? When we look at Bo Wallace, everybody's going to say, I know Bo. I was there when Bo was a senior quarterback and beat Alabama.
Hang on.
One last timeout by Alabama.
Yes.
Forevermore. Bo Wallace will be able to come to the Grove and tell the story about how he quarterbacked the upset against the number one team, Alabama.
Ole Miss is about to go 5-0. The last time Ole Miss was 5-0, the president of the United States was John Fitzgerald Kennedy.
And how about a day for the state of Mississippi? Mississippi State wins big. And now Ole Miss knocks off Alabama. Hugh Freeze takes his football teams and knocks them off.
They're rushing the field. Bo Wallace wants to keep that football, and why would he not? It is the first time Ole Miss has ever defeated a top-ranked team.
Next home game in 2 weeks against the University of Tennessee for homecoming. And on your way home, wherever you do head home, please drive carefully.
Information director Langston Rogers, who is a dear. Langston, I'm yelling at you. Did you ever think you'd see this day? He's a traitor. My gosh. Hotty toddy indeed.
As this wonderful seed explodes, one last football note from me. We talked about at halftime that Ole Miss needed some offense. They had 105 yards. Only way they could win. Well, they put 218 yards on Alabama, the most Alabama's given up in the second half in 2 years. We know Bo.
Yes, we.
We met him yesterday.
Well, I think back to our conversation. He said, "You, Gary asked Bo, do you resent the term that you're inconsistent?
Right.
And he said, well, I sometimes think I'm the only person in America who's ever thrown an interception.
And he also, our coach, his coach, Hugh Freeze, talked about him, as other great players, but he's been through so much criticism. People have talked about how he has not gone out on Thursday nights. He's really buckled in. And I said, Bo, if you win this one, I'm going to let you go out on Saturday night. Have a good time. And he assured me he would.
Got a haircut for this game. Now, the Oxford Square is one of the great public squares in America. I don't think you and I want to go anywhere close to that tonight.
I can't imagine, if you're an Ole Miss fan, what this feels like. All those years.
Somewhere in the middle of this mass of humanity is Hugh Freeze, who is with Allie LaForce.
Coach, I don't know where the camera is, but we're just going to chat. Ole Miss has never beaten a top-ranked opponent. What are you feeling right now?
God is good to us. He's blessed us in our 2.5 years here. I'm just so proud of the resilience of our kids, you know. That fumble right before half felt like it ripped my heart out. Our kids just kept fighting. And to beat a quality team who's been the gold standard in our conference it expedites our process for sure.
You said your goal was to make Ole Miss a household name. Do you feel like you did that today?
Yeah, we're close. We're close. We've recruited well. Our administration supports us so well. We got the greatest fans in the world. And, we're not as deep as I'd like for us to be, but this will help us with those recruits for sure.
Coach, congratulations. Enjoy the moment.
Allie, thank you.
Well, it's now time to present the plays of the game presented by Napa Auto Parts. First, what turned out to be the winning touchdown, Bo Wallace, Jalen Walton. It was reviewed and determined a legal catch. And then, toward the end of the game, Cinquez Golson goes up. Initially, it was called incomplete out of the end zone. It was reviewed and ruled an interception. And the first time since 1962, the Ole Miss Rebels are 5-0. How lucky are we?
Yeah, we've had some good games, one right after another.
Well, for Gary Danielson, Allie LaForce, Vern Lundquist saying so long from Oxford, our guys in the truck, Craig Silver, Steve Milton, our guys up here, David Moulton, Butch Baird, Chuck Gardner. The Dodge postgame show is up after these messages. And a word from your local station.